Only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why, there is only one God, La ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf, and I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu, wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome again to the best of stories from the Quran. In previous episodes, especially with the story of the birth of Musa alayhi salam, I have stressed the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has identified the way through which a change of nations occurs and takes place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wanted to empower the children of Israel in earth, He revealed to a mother to prepare your child. Then, brothers and sisters in Islam, raising our children is the way to go to change the condition of the Muslim Ummah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, raising Muslim believing children right now is one of the most challenging tasks and missions for a person who believes in Allah and believes in the day of resurrection. For a Muslim who believes that children are a bounty from Allah bestowed upon him. Yes, your children are a bounty from Allah bestowed upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذُّكُورِ أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكْرَانًا وَإِنَاثًا وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا. To Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. He grants يَهَبُ, He bestows upon whom He wills females, and upon whom He wills males, and sometimes both. And He sometimes, subhanahu wa ta'ala, makes some people barren. So it is a bounty upon you. In order to show gratefulness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for these children, raising them as Muslims, as believers, equipping them with the tools, with the experience, with Islam, is the best way to show gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, raising Muslim believing children at this time is one of the most difficult tasks, challenging missions of a believing Muslim father or mother or Muslim parents. Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? We'll find out. But it is not an option. It is not an option. You need to understand that. We're making it sound like it's a plus to do so. No. It's a luxury to do so. No. It is mandatory upon you to raise up your children as Muslims and as believers. And you know what? It is a responsibility. يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. O ye who believe, spare, safeguard your children, yourselves and your children, a fire the fuel of which people and rocks, guarded by angels who are stern. They disobey Allah not, and they do what Allah commanded them to do. Brothers and sisters in Islam, your children are responsibility upon you, and you will be asked about it. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, in explaining this verse, he said, the only way for you to spare them from the hellfire is by teaching them the deen. علموهم الدين. Teach them Islam. Bring them up as Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, and the hadith in the two sahih, حديث عبد الله بن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنهما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كلكم راع. All of you are custodian. وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. And all of you will be asked about their custody in the day of resurrection. Allah will ask you as a parent, as a father, as a mother, why didn't you teach them to pray? Why didn't you teach them the deen? Allah will ask you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, your children are amana. You're entrusted with these children.
Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la takhunu Allah wa rasul wa takhunu amanatikum wa antum ta'lamun. واعلموا أنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة وأن الله عنده أجر عظيم.
O ye who believe, betray not Allah, betray not the messenger, betray not the things that you are entrusted with. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions your wealth and your children, you are entrusted with those. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if you do not bring up your children as Muslims, as believers, you will be a loser in this world. A loser after you die in the graveyard, and a loser in the day of resurrection. A loser in this world, they will not be dutiful to you. I tell you something. If you do not teach your children Islam, if you do not teach your children Tawheed, the oneness of Allah, they will not be kind to you. If you look into the verses in the Quran that commanded the children to be dutiful to the parents, you will find them coming in sequence right away after La ilaha illallah.
وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا.
Dear parents, if you do not teach your children La ilaha illallah, they will not be kind. They will not be kind to you. They will not be dutiful to you. If you do not teach them the fear of Allah, they will not fear Allah in you. You will lose their birr, their kind treatment in this world, because they fear nobody. After you die, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, and the hadith is sahih Muslim, hadith Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمْ أَوْ مَاتَ الْإِنسَانِ. If the son of Adam dies, انْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثِ. When they take you and dig a hole in the ground and bury you, no more good deeds except from three sources. One of them is what? وَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يَدْعُوا لَهُ. Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say a child who will invoke the mercy of Allah upon you. No, it's restricted with what? صالح, a righteous child. Dear parents, if you have not contributed, if you have not contributed to the righteousness and piety of your children in this world, how are you expecting them to make dua for you after you leave this world? You tell me. You answer me, brothers and sisters. You answer me. In the hereafter, a loser. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Az-Zumar, قُلْ, tell them, O Muhammad, إن الخاسرين الذين خسروا أنفسهم وأهليهم يوم القيامة ألا ذلك هو الخسران المبين. You know, in this world, if your child temperature goes up, you rush to the emergency room. How can you bear your child being grabbed to the hellfire before your eyes? Save them, brothers and sisters in Islam. Save your children. You love them. Save them. Teach them the deen. Take them to the masjids. Teach them how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure that they learn tawheed. Make sure that they learn the oneness of Allah. Make sure that they memorize some of the Quran or the Quran, all of the Quran, brothers and sisters in Islam. The ummah are in need for your children. We need your children. You have an asset that can be invested for the welfare of this ummah. If you care about the ummah, do it. Prepare your children. I know it's very challenging. I know it's very difficult. I know it's very hard at this time to bring up Muslim children, to bring up a Muslim child, to bring up children who are believing, because you're not alone. You're not alone. You're not alone. But you know what? If you place your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver you and will deliver your child. Let's take a short break and come back and explain more why it is so challenging to raise up Muslim believing children at this time and offer the solutions, because we got to do it as an ummah. That is our way out. We got to do it. And this will lead us to the stories that I want to share with you regarding this issue. Let's take a short break and come back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.
Ask Hoda.
If you're still in Mecca or close by to Mecca, then you have to know that you are still in the state of Ihram. As long as it is not for sale, then he does not have to pay zakah for it. Forbade praying witr, similar to Maghrib prayer. So whoever prays witr three rak'ahs and sitting after the second rak'ah as if he's praying Maghrib prayer, this is forbidden, this is haram. To euthanasia is permissible with animals, but not with human beings. If an animal is suffering, killing an animal for a legitimate reason is permissible. Both are acceptable, but the majority say that after the rukuh is the place of qunut. But both was reported.
Have a question or concern on your mind? Hoda TV decided, based on popular demand, we will be bringing you an additional episode of Ask Hoda with Sheikh Azim bin Luqman al-Hakim, live from Jeddah, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome back to the best of stories from the Quran. This episode today is an introduction to more than one story that has to be told And it has to do with the raising up of our children as Muslims and as believers, because this is the way out for our ummah, the new generation. I speak to the imams of the masjids. I speak to the leaders of the communities. I speak to the parents. You hold the solution in your hands. Pay attention to the next generation of Muslims. Make sure that you're equipping them with the proper teaching of this religion, the proper tawheed, the proper deen. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I am a parent myself, and I live in the Western world. And I have to admit that it is very difficult to raise up believing Muslim children at the time, because you're not alone. You see, there are three main institutions that must collaborate in bringing up a good believing child. Home, which is you. The masjid. You must make sure that the teachings in the masjid are the Quran and the Sunnah, not bid'ah, not innovations. And they are united. And the children like to be in the masjid. Number three is the school. And I'm talking about an Islamic school. An Islamic school, brothers and sisters in Islam. A piece of advice. If you cannot afford it, homeschooling. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is also difficult, because a lot of parents are not aware that in our religion, in our deen, we have a curriculum, we have guidelines, we have manuscripts in how to bring up Muslim children. We don't know. A lot of parents, they don't even know. So what they end up doing? They end up adopting methodology or ways or the ways of the non-Muslims in bringing up the Muslim children, and then they are expecting the children to be Muslims. Give me a break. How this will be? For example, to bring up a Muslim child begins before you marry. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the people who are seeking women in marriage, the men who are seeking women in marriage, Hadith al-Bukhari, Hadith Abi Huraira, tunkahul mar'atu li arba. A woman is asked for marriage because of four incentives: jamaliha, her physical beauty; maliha, her wealth; hasabiha, her lineage; walidiniha, and her religion. Look, fadfar bidhati ad-din taribat yadak. Choose the one with the religion, because in fact you are choosing a mother for your child. You're not only choosing a wife for you. No, you're selecting a mother for your child. So you better choose the one with the deen. For the sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the guardians of the sisters, إِذَا جَاءَكُمْ مَنْ تَرْضَوْنَ خُلُقَهُ وَدِينَهُ فَزَوُّجُوهُ إِلَّا تَفْعَلُوا تَكُمْ فِتْنَةٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَفَسَادٌ كَبِيرٌ. If someone comes to ask your guardianship, your daughters, your sisters, whomever is in your guardianship in marriage, and you're content, happy with their manners and their deen, give them your daughters, your sisters in marriage. If you do not, corruption, because you are choosing a father for their children. Brothers and sisters in Islam, what is the solution? The solution, brothers and sisters in Islam, is you must make sure that you're doing this for Allah. If you want a solution, be sincere. Bring up your children for Allah. Rabbi waladaka lillah, lillah, lillah. Do it for Allah, and Allah will guide you. Believe in the things that I said, that your children are in trust. Your children are a responsibility. They are a bounty. You're going to be losing if you do not bring up your children as Muslims. They are an asset for the ummah. Believe in this. And that should drive you to be sincere in bringing them up as Muslims and as believers. Sincerity. Two, trust Allah. Trust Allah. subhanahu wa ta'ala. I was delivering a talk in one of the masjids, and one of the sisters asked me this question: why should we have children? A Muslim mother or sister. Why should we have children when the ratio of them going astray is way up there? She's right. It's very difficult. But what happened to trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Tawakkul. Trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no guarantees. In previous episodes, I narrated to you the story of the two sons of Adam. One of them was righteous, and the other one was a killer. And I narrated with you the story of the son of Noah, Nuh, alayhi salam. What about Musa? You know who brought up Musa? Who? The Pharaoh. And he ended up to be a messenger of Allah. Later on, inshallah, in one of the episodes, I will narrate to you the story of the boy and the king. The whole kingdom has infested the resources to bring out a sorcerer. And they ended up bringing up a caller to Allah. There is no guarantees. What you have to do is you have to do it for Allah, and then you have to place your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But here is what you need to do. And this actually is the kickoff point for me to begin narrating the stories that I want to narrate to serve that meaning, to confirm that meaning. That you are the gate. You are the doorway to the righteousness and piety of your child. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ, Allah said, safeguard you first, yourself first, and then your children. Brothers and sisters in Islam, if your child does not see you praying, they will not pray. Except there are some exceptions, for sure. If your child sees you lying, they will end up lying. Cheating, they will end up cheating. If they see you prostrating, they will prostrate. They love you. They will mimic you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, parents and the sunnah of the parents has been always what confronted the prophets and the messengers. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ فِي قَرْيَةٍ مِنْ نَذِيرٍ إِلَّا قَالَ مُتْرَفُوهَا إِنَّا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا عَلَىٰ أُمَّ وَإِنَّا عَلَىٰ آثَرِهِمْ مُقْتَدُونَ. O Muhammad, we have not sent a messenger before you, a warner before you in a town, but the people will say, listen, we like what we have found our parents doing. So they love you. They mimic you. So if you could be the hindrance, you could hinder your children from following the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you are following the path of Allah, it will be easy for them. Brothers and sisters in Islam, in this episode, I want to share with you a very short story. And inshallah, the following two episodes, I will narrate to you more stories that confirm the fact that if you're righteous and pious, your children will be likewise. The story that I want to share with you today quickly is the story of that righteous, patient son. Amazing. When his father took him and explained to him that he received a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through a dream that he is to slaughter him.
فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعْيَ قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ افْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرُ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ.
Ya Allah, his father is telling him that I received a command from Allah through a dream to slaughter you. He said, what? Do what Allah commanded you to do, because you will find me amongst the patients, amongst those who are patient, inshallah. I don't want to focus on the child, on the 2 minutes I still have. No, I want to focus on who is the father and who is the mother. The father is Ibrahim. The Prophet ﷺ said that people will be resurrected in the day of resurrection naked, And the first one who will be garment will be given a garment to wear will be Ibrahim. You know why? Because he stood in front of the fire naked for La ilaha illallah, refusing to compromise. Who is the mother? A woman whom her husband Ibrahim alayhi salam was commanded by Allah to take her to the desert and leave her alone with her baby Ismail alayhi salam in the desert, and all what she needed to know. Ya Ibrahim, O Ibrahim, did Allah command you to do this? أمرك الله بهذا. Three times. At the end, he had to leave her with something. He said yes. She told him, go, because it's a command from Allah. Go. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never waste us. إذن لن يضيعنا. إذن لن يضيعنا. Allah will not waste us. You see the righteousness. Can you imagine? Ibrahim plus Hajar. The righteousness and piety. Who is the child? Ismail. Brothers and sisters in Islam, your righteousness and piety is the door, is the gate to the righteousness and piety of your children. This is where you need to begin. Till the next episode of the best of stories. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why, there is only one God, la ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf, and I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome again to the best of stories from the Quran. In previous episodes, especially with the story of the birth of Musa alayhi salam, I have stressed the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has identified the way through which a change of nations occurs and takes place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wanted to empower the children of Israel in earth, He revealed to a mother to prepare your child. Then, brothers and sisters in Islam, raising our children is the way to go to change the condition of the Muslim father or mother or Muslim parents. Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? We'll find out. But it is not an option. It is not an option. You need to understand that. We're making it sound like it's a plus to do so. No. It's a luxury to do so. No. It is mandatory upon you to raise up your children as Muslims and as believers. And you know what? It is a responsibility.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم وما.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, raising Muslim believing children right now is one of the most challenging tasks and missions for a person who believes in Allah and believes in the day of resurrection. For a Muslim who believes that children are a bounty from Allah bestowed upon him. Yes, your children are a bounty from Allah bestowed upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لله ملك السماوات والأرض يخلق ما يشاء يهب لمن يشاء إناثا ويهب لمن يشاء الذكور
أو يزوجهم ذكرانا وإناثا ويجعل من يشاء عقيما. To Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth.
Only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why, there is only one God, La ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf, and I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh, wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. He grants يهب, He bestows upon whom He wills females, and upon whom He wills males, and sometimes both. And he sometimes, subhanahu wa ta'ala, makes some people barren. So it is a bounty upon you. In order to show gratefulness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for these children, raising them as Muslims, as believers, equipping them with the tools, with the experience, with Islam, is the best way to show gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, raising Muslim believing children at this time is one of the most difficult tasks, challenging tasks, challenging missions of a believing Muslim.